Hi, I'm Klaus Lunge Christensen, and in this short video I will show you a little bit about import of DXF files into the ODEON Room Acoustics program. So we go to the file menu and select the import from file, and you can import DXF files and 3DS files and stereolithography files, and we'll try that. And this is how you import CAD models into ODEON. So let's go to my repository of DXF files, and I'll import this bistro. So I select the files, and I indicate where to save the imported file. I've already imported it, so it actually does exist already. ODEON supports a number of CAD entities, 3D face and polyline meshes and polyfaces and so on, and a number of other more rare types of drawing entities which are used for surface drawings in some CAD programs. First I will import the file in the preview setup. ODEON import and compile the raw surfaces and clean up, remove duplicates and so on, and now we are ready to view it. What you'll see now is that it's a pretty messy file. We have some things that definitely don't belong to our room, and here is the model, the 3D model we are interested in. What you can also see that it contains a large number of triangles and so on. It contains some flat drawings, so this is all the things that are in the CAD drawing. But we can have ODEON refine this, not only remove duplicate surfaces and surfaces that have no area, but also glue together surfaces. Now I would select the default setting in ODEON, and the glue surfaces option is turned on, and it will stitch together surfaces that are almost in the same plane and have joining points, forming geometry with far fewer surfaces. Before we had almost 13,000 surfaces, and I believe now when we import with gluing we will have something like 3,500 surfaces. Yeah, here we have it, 3,500 surfaces in the final drawing. And you can see it's much clearer, it's much more compatible with the way that ODEON handle calculations, because the surfaces and their areas correspond to meaningful areas in the geometry and how this will scatter sound. So this is very good from a computational point of view. Also, if you want to put this drawing in a report, you can use the copy to clipboard here to copy the graphics into a Word document, for example. Then this looks much nicer in a report than what you saw before, which was very messy. So you can imagine this looks okay in a report. The other one wouldn't be very meaningful, so this is definitely much better. When you import from an AutoCAD drawing, layers are maintained. Now I open the layer list. You can find it up in the 3D view here, or you can use the Ctrl L shortcut. And we have some 20 layers here. And if we enable the layers, you can see the surfaces appear in different colors. And this is very practical when you need to assign materials, because then you can enable a layer at a time and assign the materials to each of the layers. Instead of assigning different materials to each surface, you can just assign to these 20 layers maybe one at a time, instead of handling each of these 3,500 surfaces individually. Now, often when you import a CAD drawing, there might be some surfaces missing, and if you're not having AutoCAD on your own PC, you don't have a license for it, then it might be very practical that you can repair a geometry in ODEON. Now I enabled the modeling an option in ODEON, and it can help you to repair a geometry, for example put windows into open window holes and so forth. Often an architect will not put windows in the geometry because visually a window is transparent, but from an acoustic point of view it's indeed very important to have the windows there, otherwise you would have a lot of absorption from the open window holes. Now having done this, we can click the points like this, to grab points. And this is not a full-featured CAD program, CAD modeling program, but it can help you to repair some minor details in the geometry, and it's not too hard to use. Now I opened the parametric, the geometry file, the imported file, and I will just paste what I just created by clicking in my drawing. So what that did was to add this text to the Windows text clipboard, and this is the specification for the surface I want to have inside ODEON. Now I reopen ODEON, and you'll see the geometry again. It didn't take too long time. And if I try to click on the surface, you'll see that indeed we do have a surface here we just modeled. So it's possible to make small patchings for your geometry, even though you don't have the relevant CAD modeling program. So I think this is just about what I wanted to show. I could also do ray tracing in the geometry now. It's actually finished. We just would need to assign a source and some materials, and then we can do that as well. If you look into this 3D OpenGL rendered view, you will see the geometry we imported, and except that it's random colors because we didn't assign materials yet, it looks pretty nice. So it's possible to use CAD drawings, and because of this stitching ODEON has, and because of the cleanup ODEON automatically performs, then it becomes quite useful. I would just show here in the bottom of the imported geometry file from ODEON that ODEON actually removes 608 surfaces automatically because they are duplicate surfaces. So ODEON analyzes each surface to see if there's one that matches it and remove duplicates. And if you would do that manually in the CAD drawing, it would be impossible. So you would not be able to use it for your simulations, or you would have a very poorly specified geometry where you don't know which surface should you actually assign which material to. So I think this concludes my point of importing DXF drawings into ODEON, and I hope you find it useful. Thank you.